Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. From the house of the Lord, we bless you. Our reading for today is found in the Gospel of Matthew chapter 5, verse 13. You are the salt of the earth, but if the salt loses its flavor, how can it be made salty again? It is no longer good for anything except to be thrown out and trampled underfoot by men. The value of salt is the title of this sermon. In his famous Sermon on the Mount, Jesus says that the faithful are like salt of the earth. Today, this phrase is understood to mean an honest person with true character that can endure hardship like salt. But what did Jesus really mean when it was spoken 2,000 years ago? In the original Hebrew, Jesus called his followers the salt of the earth, but the Gospels do not explain the meaning of this famous saying. As is the case today, in the days of the Bible, salt was used to season and preserve food from rotting in the warm climate of Israel. Jesus was telling his followers to behave morally in order to improve the quality and preserve the goodness of the world around them. Back in the Old Testament, God made a covenant with the Hebrews called a covenant of salt. And because of its protective powers, salt became a symbol of integrity. Integrity means to be totally honest. This covenant was to be an everlasting covenant. God's people in any age and under any condition are both salt and light in the world. If the salt has lost its flavor, how can it season the world? The problem today is that most believers have lost their flavor. We have very few salted Christians in our day. Believers are to be the salt of the earth and have an influence for good in the world. This is a tremendous principle for us. We must be salt that gives flavor regardless. The Bible tells us that the Holy Spirit will guide us to all truth. John chapter 16 and verse 13. That truth is the Word of God. John chapter 17 and verse 17. When we witness to people, we add flavor to the lost soul with the Word of God. Let your speech be always with grace, seasoned with salt, that you may know how to answer everyone. Colossians chapter 4 and verse 6. The Sermon on the Mount is God-centered. During the millennium, during the kingdom here on earth, everything which is done and said will be God-centered. And in this present age, in this lost world in which we live in, our prime motivation should be to bring glory to God. This is something that every Christian should consider very seriously. The aim and purpose of our lives should be to glorify God. The question arises, have you lost your saltiness? This world without Christ has no flavor. The cross and the resurrection has seasoned our world. For though the righteous fall seven times, he rises again. Proverbs chapter 24. In verse 16, it is when you rise again that you regain your saltiness. God's word is eternal and it stands firm in the heavens. Psalm 119 in verse 89. His word is more than enough to make you salty again. His Holy Spirit will always give you the right flavor of his holiness. My friend, you are the salt of the earth. The earth needs salt in order to taste what is good. Psalm chapter 34 and verse 8. May the name of the Lord be praised now and forevermore. Amen.